Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Shreya Vijay. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Tuesday, the 23rd of March. India, Pakistan should resolve issues through dialogue, says top Pakistan envoy. Pakistan People's Party wins crucial Jamaat-e-Islami's vote for Senate office. And thousands congregate to celebrate Holi with sweets in India amid pandemic. And now for all the details. Top Pakistani diplomat in India, Aftab Hasan Khan, said on Tuesday that his country wants good neighbourly relations, especially with India, and both the countries should resolve all bilateral issues through dialogue. His statement came as top officials of India and Pakistan began a two-day meeting in New Delhi to discuss Indus River water sharing after a gap of nearly 2 years.
Charge Day Affairs of Pakistan High Commission in India, Aftab Hasan Khan on Tuesday said his country wants good neighbourly relations, especially with India, and wants to solve all bilateral issues with negotiations through dialogue. He made the remarks while addressing a gathering at the Pakistan High Commission in New Delhi to celebrate Pakistan Day, which commemorates the passing of the Lahore Resolution on March 23, 1940. When the All India Muslim League demanded a separate nation for the Muslims of the British Indian Empire.
Pakistan apne tamam padosiyon ke saath acche taluqaat chahta hai. Amn o salamati ke liye ye zaruri hai ki hamare beech tamam masail baatcheet ke zariye se hal hon.
Meanwhile, after a gap of nearly 2 years, a 7-member Pakistani delegation arrived in India to hold a two-day meeting with their counterparts to discuss Indus water sharing between the two nations on Tuesday. The Indus Water Treaty warrants the two sides to meet once a year, alternately in India and Pakistan. The development comes exactly a month after militaries of India and Pakistan announced a joint ceasefire agreement along their de facto border in Kashmir, having exchanged fire hundreds of times in recent months.
India will start vaccinating all people above 45 years of age from April 1 against the coronavirus, even if they have no comorbidities, Union Minister Prakash Javdekar informed on Tuesday. This comes as India has been reporting a surge in infections and was giving vaccines to only frontline workers and those over 60 years of age, and for people aged 45 and above with comorbid conditions.
India's Union Minister Prakash Javdekar on Tuesday informed the government, after consulting experts, has approved vaccination for all above 45 years of age, even if they have no comorbidities. The minister also said the second vaccine dose across the country could be administered between the 4th and 8th week, particularly for COVID Shield. First phase of India's nationwide COVID-19 vaccination drive started in January with healthcare and frontline workers. The second phase of the inoculation commenced in March with those who were over 60 years of age and for people age 45 and above with comorbid conditions.
So from 1st of April, anybody who is over 45 age will get vaccination even though he has no comorbidities. उसके लिए उसे अब कोई दाखिला लाने की सर्टिफिकेट लाने की जरूरत नहीं है।
India on Tuesday recorded 40,715 new coronavirus cases and 199 related fatalities. According to Health Ministry, 6 states including Maharashtra, Punjab, Kerala, Karnataka, Gujarat and Madhya Pradesh have been reporting the surge in daily new cases and together count for over 80% of the new infections reported in a day in India.
In news from Pakistan, Pakistan People's Party Chairman Bilawal Bhutto Zardari has managed to convince the Jamaat-e-Islami Party for their support towards Syed Yusuf Raza Gilani, its candidate for the post of the opposition leader in the Senate. This comes as differences between the opposition alliance PDM had come to surface over the nomination to the key office.
Pakistan's Jamaat-e-Islami Party has decided to support Pakistan People's Party's candidate Syed Yusuf Raza Gilani for the post of opposition leader in the Senate. This comes as differences within the Pakistan Democratic Movement on the nomination of opposition leader in the Senate came to surface over the past weekend when both the Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz and Bilawal's Pakistan People's Party publicly claimed their rights to the key office. Since then, both the parties had started lobbying for the office and Bilawal had started talking to such political parties like Jamaat-e-Islami to seek their support for his party's candidate, local media reports claimed. At present, the Pakistan People's Party has 21 senators on opposition benches, where the Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz with 17 members is the second largest party in the upper house.
Moving on. Baloch activist Munir Mengel, during his intervention at the ongoing UNHRC session in Geneva on Monday, expressed concern over the persecution of innocent Baloch people by Pakistan and the state-sponsored terrorism in the region. He blamed there is worst kind of subjugation in Balochistan.
President of Baloch Voice Association Munir Mengel, on Monday, during his intervention at the ongoing UNHRC session in Geneva, raised concern over persecution of Baloch people by Pakistan and the state-sponsored terrorism in the region. The Baloch activist said that in Balochistan there is worst kind of subjugation and highlighted alleged killings of innocent Baloch people by state forces, including the infamous cases of 4-year-old Bramsh Baloch and university student Hayat Baloch, which he said are high signs of systematic discrimination and xenophobia being practiced by Pakistan.
Systematic military operations, displacements, enforced disappearances, deprivation from presenting their culture, reading, writing their mother languages, barred from cultural norms and traditions, etc. Thus, not only their souls, in fact, their identity is being eliminated.
Munir Mengel also expressed concern that terror groups including Lashkar-e-Taiba, Lashkar-e-Jhangvi have penetrated deeply inside Balochistan and Jamaat-ud-Dawah leaders roam freely in the region, which are signs of state-backing activities.
In news from Afghanistan, the Taliban has said it has shared a 3-month-long reduction in violence plan with the US, but there has been no overall agreement on the proposal so far, according to Afghan local media reports. This comes after U.S. Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin raised concern over high level of violence in the country during an unannounced visit to Kabul this past weekend.
The Taliban has shared a 90-day reduction in violence plan with the United States, but there has been no overall agreement on the plan so far, Afghan local media reports suggested. Taliban spokesman Mohammad Naeem said that the reduction in violence will not mean a ceasefire, but it will result in a decrease in all operations by the group in Afghanistan, the Tolo News reported. This comes after U.S. Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin paid an unannounced visit to Kabul on his first trip to Afghanistan as Pentagon chief, during which he met Afghan President Ashraf Ghani and voiced concern about the high level of violence in the country. The meeting comes at a crucial time for the Afghan peace process ahead of a May 1 deadline for the withdrawal of U.S. troops agreed by the insurgent Taliban and the administration of previous U.S. President Donald Trump. The Taliban has said they would like to see the process sped up, but warned Washington against keeping troops in Afghanistan beyond their agreed withdrawal date.
Moving on to news from Bangladesh. A massive fire swept through a Rohingya refugee camp in southern Bangladesh on Monday afternoon, gutting hundreds of tents and a number of health centers and other facilities. Locals in the camp said several people had died, but neither the authorities nor the UNHCR have yet confirmed the number of deaths. A huge fire swept through a Rohingya refugee camp in southern Bangladesh on Monday, destroying thousands of homes and killing several people, officials and witnesses said. Rohingya refugees in the camp said many homes were burned down and several people had died, but neither the authorities nor the UNHCR could confirm the number of deaths. The cause of the blaze has not been established. The UNHCR said humanitarian partners had mobilized hundreds of volunteers from nearby camps for the support operation, as well as fire safety vehicles and equipment. More than a million Rohingya live in the camps in southern Bangladesh, the vast majority having fled Myanmar in 2017 from a military-led crackdown that UN investigators said was executed with genocidal intent, charges Myanmar denies. Another large blaze tore through the camp in January, destroying homes but causing no casualties. Car lovers gathered to see vintage cars at a rally organized by the Goa Vintage and Classic Vehicles Club in India's western Panaji city over the past weekend. The rally aimed at promoting restoration of classic vehicles.
Around 60 vintage cars rolled out on the roads of India's western Panaji city over the past weekend at the Vintage Car Rally. The event organized by the Goa Vintage and Classic Vehicles Club saw car lovers gather in the beach city to see the vintage beauties on the road once again.
This is one way that the cultural identity of a country is displayed. I think you see the number of people here today on the roads. It's a great occasion for a Sunday. People are enjoying themselves. You have to give it to the owners of these cars who take so much trouble to maintain it. I think they are maintaining their family heritage. So I think from that perspective, it's an extremely important event.
It's amazing. I got to witness all types of vintage cars. And it's a very appealing to me.
The rally, which was postponed due to the coronavirus lockdown, was aimed at promoting restoration of vintage cars.
Thousands of devotees gathered at a temple in India's Mathura district on Monday to play Laddu Holi with sweets, which marks the beginning of celebrations of the Hindu festival of colours in the region. Though Holi is a single-day festival elsewhere in India, it is almost a 10-day affair in Mathura.
Thousands of devotees gathered in India's northern Mathura district on Monday to play Laddu Holi, which marks the beginning of celebrations of Holi, the Hindu festival of colours. Smeared in different colours, the devotees from across India gathered at Sri Radharani Temple in Mathura amid surging coronavirus cases in the country to mark the festival associated with the eternal love of Hindu Lord Krishna and his consort Radha. As part of the ritual, traditional ball-shaped sweet meat, laddus, were flung at devotees from the temple's terrace, and they in turn were seen competing with each other to catch the holy offering while flouting mask and social distancing rules.
राधा रानी और कृष्ण के प्रेम की लड्डू होली है ये आज से होली की शुरुआत होगी इसलिए लड्डू से खेली जाती है ताकि इसे मिठास बनी रहे सबके बीच में
कोरोना की बात की जाए कौन है कोरोना कैसे कोरोना भाई हमें ना पता ब्रिजवासी इनके लिए कछुना है तो कोरोना कोरोना फरोना यहाँ पे कछुना है
Celebrated at the onset of spring, Holi also holds a mythological importance, that of the triumph of good over evil. Though Holi is a single-day festival elsewhere in India, it is almost a 10-day affair in Mathura.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude the top stories once again. India, Pakistan should resolve issues through dialogue, says top Pakistan envoy. Pakistan People's Party wins crucial Jamaat-e-Islami's vote for Senate office. And thousands congregate to celebrate Holi with sweets in India amid pandemic. Now, viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/SAsianewsline and follow us on Twitter at SAsianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.